Turning now to Egypt. There are calls in Cairo for a million-man march on Friday as pro-democracy demonstrators demand an end to military rule. It follows a large rally yesterday led by female protesters, outraged over the violent treatment of women by soldiers during last week's clashes. NBC's Ahmed Mohideen was on the scene in Cairo, and just a warning, some of these images are disturbing.
It was the largest women's protest anyone here has ever seen. Thousands of Egyptian women marched across Tahrir Square, calling on their countrymen to join them and demand an end to the abuse of women demonstrators. This is what has sparked their anger. Recent attacks against women protesters captured on video. One woman seemed beaten senseless by Egyptian soldiers, her limp and exposed body then dragged away as another soldier stomps on her chest. A man and woman walking by are then dragged into the violence. They too are viciously beaten. These shocking images quickly spread around the world, triggering international outrage and condemnation.
Women are being beaten and humiliated in the same streets where they risked their lives for the revolution only a few short months ago.
The images were also broadcast on Egyptian state television, helping unite political forces against the ruling generals.
The targeting of women has angered many across the society, and they've organized this protest to send a very clear message to the military rulers that the abuse of women at the hands of the security forces will no longer be accepted.
28-year-old pharmacist Reda Kemal was shielding another woman when soldiers assaulted her. She said, "They stomped on my face with their boots and clubbed me on my head. Then they took me to a holding area with seven other women and threatened to rape me." The women's protest is part of a new uprising here, pushing the military to give up power. The military is pushing back, showing footage of what it said were thugs attacking soldiers, insisting the soldiers acted with restraint and in self-defense. But in the same video, military personnel can be seen firing at demonstrators at close range. When Egypt's uprising began 10 months ago, demonstrators trusted the military to protect the revolution. But for many, that trust is now gone.
That was NBC's Ahmed Mohideen reporting. The country's ruling military council issued a rare apology for what it called violations of female protesters and vowed to punish those responsible for the abuse.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us.
Team HillaryClinton.com.